G'day and welcome back. Last time we talked about the E6B flight computer. It's my favorite navigation tool. It's just so handy and I really love how quickly you can do calculations of speed, time and distance and conversions and that type of thing. What we're going to talk about tonight is how to do some conversions. We're going to do the conversions from Celsius to Fahrenheit in temperature. We're going to do some distance conversions from kilometers to nautical and statute miles and back again. And we're also going to do some conversions from liters through to US gallons. So let's get started. So the first conversion we're going to do with the E6B is a temperature conversion. And this is really, really simple. On the bottom of the flight computer is a fixed scale that has Celsius along one and Fahrenheit along the other. And you simply read from one to the other to get the conversion. It's no more complex than that. So that you can see that 0 degrees Celsius is about 32 degrees Fahrenheit. 60 degrees Fahrenheit is about 15 degrees Celsius. You can see minus 30 degrees Celsius is minus 22 degrees Fahrenheit. So that's a really, really simple way to get those calculations very quickly. So the next conversion we're going to do is equally simple, and that's the conversion from kilometers to nautical miles and to statute miles and back. And that's all done here along this fixed scale. You can see here at the 12 mark is the kilometer mark, and around here between 80 and sort of 65 are the statute miles mark and the nautical miles mark. And all you do is at these three arrows, you simply read off the value. So that if you have, and we'll spin the wheel a little bit, let's say you have 140 kilometers. You put 140 kilometers on the kilometer scale, and then you can read that as statute and nautical. So 140 kilometers is 87 statute miles, and it's about 76 nautical miles. Really, really easily. Similarly, if you want to go to put 60 nautical miles in, you bring the 60 mark around to the nautical mile scale over here, and then you can read off your statute miles or your kilometers. So statute miles is about 69 statute miles, and the reading here in kilometers is about 111 kilometers. So once again, a really easy, quick conversion. It's as simple as that. The final conversion I'm going to show you is the conversion between litres and US gallons of fuel. We'll also do imperial gallons as well if you're interested in that. So for those measurements, the US gallons is here near the 13, litres is over here near the 50 on the outer scale, and imperial gallons is here between 10 and 11 on the outer scale. So let's say you have 400 litres, you want to convert that to US gallons. You bring the 40 for 400 around to the litres mark here. So we bring that around there, like that. And then you can read off your US gallons. So 40 litres is about, 14 US gallons. Imperial gallons, it's about it's about 8.75 imperial gallons. So thanks very much for watching. If you like this show, then please make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to see more, then go ahead and subscribe. And if you have any comments, then leave them below. And certainly if you've got any suggestions of ideas for navigation type of shows, then I'd love to hear them and we'll try and put them on for you. So we will catch you soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.